have you been grinding a lot of mushrooms and buying a lot of pets? But do you keep wondering, how are other people's pets better than mine? How do other people get so many Quistelic pets? And how do I get them? If that is what you are thinking right now, then this guide will be for you. Hello everybody, my name is Bowie. And today I will showcase you how to get the best pets possible in Wizard Legends on Roblox. You are probably wondering if you can do this guide without having a lot of mushrooms. And you can, because this method works even on the cheapest pets, like the Wet at the spawn area. In fact, for this video, I will showcase you how breeding works on the Wet. But you can do this on any pet in the game. Personally, I have done it on my VIP pets. As you can see at my pets, I have a lot of pets that are classified in Mushroom, Magic and Gold. I have 6 for each type so that I can switch my pets around to get the best result. You can also see that they are all epic, and some of them even have the max size. What you see right here is basically a flawless pet, and that is what we will be focusing on today. So first, you need to decide what kind of pet you want. So for this example, I want a Quistelic Splint, preferably a legendary. So we have the goals set. We want a legendary Quistelic Splint. So the first thing that you're gonna do, you're gonna go to the pet shop in which you can get the pet, and you're gonna keep re-rolling and buying eggs until you get the rarity that you want. Of course, if you are a VIP member, you want a legendary pet, but if you are not, you want the epic pet. So keep buying eggs till you get at least one legendary. It doesn't have to be the Quistelic, it just has to be a legendary. And there we have it, a legendary Fruitful Splint. And now you're probably wondering, but Bowie, you wanted a Quistelic Splint, so why are you happy with a Fruitful Splint? Well, a Fruitful is all that you need. So once you get the tier that you want, you can close the menu and go to the breeding section. So once you arrive at the breeding section, you click on the pet that you want to breed, in this case the Splint, and you pick the legendary Fruitful. So like we said, we wanted a Quistelic Splint, but first you're gonna breed it with every pet that is not a Quistelic. So this one is a Quistelic, so we are gonna skip it and put the Fruitful in. We're gonna put the Grimmering in, the Paranormal, and this is another Quistelic. Skip this, do not breed yet. Put in the Paranormal and breed. As you can see, your pet now got stronger and it will get a new prefix. In my case, I got another Fruitful. So as you can see, when we add another type, it gets more and more random. So you are probably already guessing what we're going to do at the end. If you didn't get your pet to the max size, it is not the biggest problem. I would suggest that you buy more pets and level it up to the max size first, but it is not required. I actually got another legendary. It is also a Paranormal, so that's just fine. There are two things that you can do. You can keep this legendary to do the same method as we're doing with this, or you can combine them together. it doesn't really matter. Okay guys, so if you did everything correct, you should have a max or almost maxed size legendary or epic and a whole bunch of Crystallic pets. Now all you gotta do is breed it with the Crystallics. And as you can see on the right side, it gives us a really high chance to get a Crystallic. Now you just press breed. Now if you don't get the Crystallic the first try, don't worry, because you still got a lot of other Crystallics saved up to make it a Crystallic. In this example, we got the Crystallic on our first try. Now of course, you can still put the other Crystallics in. And because all of them are Crystallic, there is a 100% chance to get a Crystallic. This way, you can pick which pets you want. Do you want pets that focus on gold? Or do you want pets that focus on mana? And here he is, our legendary max size Crystallic Splint. And it's pretty amazing. Now, of course, if you are going to really want to make a difference in this game, don't do this method on a splint. Do it on the VIP pets, because the VIP pets are really good. Or do it on some later game pets, like a fungi or even a wa. One final thing. Something that I highly recommend you do is to get at least 3 Crystallic pets, 3 fruitful pets, and 3 glimmering pets. This way you can keep switching out your pets for the best situation. Are you farming mana? Then you're gonna put on the fruitful pets. Are you farming mushrooms? Then you're gonna put on the Crystallic pets. And when you've got a bunch of mana and wanna sell it, put on the glimmering pets. This way you can make the most profit in Wizard Legends. If you are a player of Wizard Legends and you got some amazing pets with some really high stats, I would really want to hear what those are. So if you can put your team in the comments, it would really mean a lot to me. But anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!